Hello, welcome to episode 4 of our discussions of International Harvester in the 1970s and 1980s. In this episode, we're going to talk about the 2 plus 2. In this one, we'll have our usual group of panelists, and I encourage you to look at the YouTube description, and you can read about each of those people that are former leaders from the company that will be offering their information and takes on what happened. We're also going to insert some clips from Bud Youle, a very colorful sales executive who was very key in the 2 plus 2. Those clips are from a recording we did for one of my books back in July of 2016. So you're going to hear a little bit from Bud in this as well.
At the time, the decision was made that we were going to take on John Deere one-on-one. We fought them, and we held Deere at market share level. Somewhere along the line, we had to come up with something innovative, something that nobody had even conceived. But we had to also do one other thing. We couldn't spend any money. Now, that's bad when you couldn't spend any money. And all of a sudden, somebody said, what if we take an 86 rear end, put an articulation point, and put a 466 out in front of it? Bingo. I could get down 30-inch rows, 40-inch rows, and I could create a row crop tractor. I could overcome the traction problem we were starting to have because as horsepowers went up, these tires were spinning. We poured weights on them. We were packing the ground. And all of a sudden, it hit us like a light bulb. Well, the engineering people was one step ahead of us sitting in the room. They had already built a prototype model.
So Bud sees the 2 plus 2 late in the development. He becomes the person who drives the launch. They decide they want this machine launched in a big way. And this next clip, Bud is talking about a meeting he has with Stan Lancaster, who's the head of the department, head of marketing, and they are figuring out how to make this machine succeed.
I said, Stan, give me, for the Phoenix show, I said, set your chair, please. I said, I need $1,200,000. He said, Jesus Christ. I remember, that's all he said. And that was 1978, so you can see what that would be today. I remember we went upstairs and we got the money.
Yeah, Bud was something. And where we go to the 2 plus 2 is with the 2 plus 2, isn't it true, guys, that what it was quickly realized when the things were out there is people reacted negatively to the looks at times. And Bud had a great line that the first time he saw it, he said, this is the ugliest thing God ever built. But if you got people behind the wheel, it worked. And people would understand that, hey, this is a great machine.
That's true.
That was the field where we set up tents and we took these tractors. And every man, woman, and child that came to that meeting had to drive these tractors on this course. Now, the thing was, when they looked at it, when they saw this tractor, oh God. And we knew that was the thing we had to overcome. You have to take your worst aspect and make it your best feature. And that's what we did.
Well, Bud did, got the money, and then the launch, of course, was at Dick Van Dyke Studios. A very big deal. Guys, Gerry, you got a story for sure about this, and let's talk a little bit about the launch of that 2 plus 2.
If you look closely at the picture that Lee's got up, you'll see a white thing in the cab. That's my hand. when the launch plans were introduced, all the regions were asked to support this launch with personnel. And so the venue in Phoenix area, Scottsdale Carefree, was basically a launch in Dick Van Dyke Studios, a film studio. Meals at Rawhide, kind of an authentic Western town, and then out in the field, the dealers could go ahead and see the array of equipment, whether it was combines, tillage, whatever. Okay, so we fully expected as guys in the marketing regions to man, what's in the field. So got in a plane, got into Phoenix, and one of the guys from the GO. GO stands for General Office, and it also stands for God. If you heard something from GO, you stood up and it was yes, sir, and no questions. So a guy from the GO came up and said, "Salzman, we'd like you to run this tractor on stage. You're going to have to do it in the dark. Try not to hit anybody and don't drive the tractor off stage. Now, you've had a lot of experience with this tractor, haven't you? Now, how would you answer that question?" If you answered no, they'd probably ship you home and you'd end up in some godforsaken place trying to sell Cub Cadets. Or if you said yes, you could be a star and then run the tractor off the stage and hit Ben Warren and Brooks McCormick and anybody else. So that was the first time I met Roger Lovno. And Roger was responsible to make sure that tractor ran and made sure that Jerry didn't do something stupid. So it was scary, I got to tell you. The people that you see there were professional actors, dancers out of New York, and this was a stage presentation. In those days, Deer and everybody else spent millions of dollars for these product launches. So I had to drive this tractor out on stage in the dark, and then all of a sudden the lights would come on. Here comes the dancers. They even danced on top of the hood, for crying out loud. It was unbelievable. And if you don't think the reason why that hand is white is because my knuckles were white all the time. So, but what a tremendous event. But that first time driving out, there's Lancaster, all the executives that the guys have already talked about. And I thought, God, if I overshot the runway, it's going to be all over. But turned out to be an unbelievable event. First class all the way.
First class indeed. A part of this day was also a demonstration with the 2+2 going head to head with the competition. Bud Youle has that story.
We shipped a 4840. I bought one. I didn't buy it. Hinsdale Engineering had it. We shipped a 4840 with a big West Coast offset disc curl. And the 4840 at the time was 185 PTO horsepower, but Deere never shipped one less than 200 horsepower. So we set it up 200 horsepower, just like Deere would do it. So we set up 200 horsepower and put this disc curl behind it. And we took our 3588, was 150 PTO horsepower. And it pulled about 150 yards side by side. Now, I did that 10 times a day for every region overseas, and I probably won 90% of the events. And as this thing developed and it kept going, all of a sudden you could see people and dealers, by God, this concept is going to work. It's going to work.
So that tractor was a big deal. Bud had promised 6,000 orders. He claims he got 7,000. Certainly, the numbers show this sold well. The thing that was done at that demonstration was putting people behind the wheel, and that became a philosophy for these machines, getting people marketing them. And I think I know Kelly, didn't you attend one of these demos when you were a kid, correct?
Actually, when I was in college, after the 2+2 was launched, our local dealer had one of these field days and a unique opportunity to go out and drive a two-wheel drive tractor, but there was also a 2+2 there. And once you kind of got over the appearance and crawled inside, you realized, hey, this thing is really maneuverable, and it was comfortable. And it would literally fit right down the rows. So if you were in the row crop market and you needed to plant and cultivate, It was a very unique machine. It had the, you know, a totally different weight ratio. It had four equal sized tires. It had better traction and better flotation. So it really solved a lot of customer issues that they had in that day.
Excellent, excellent. And Bud does tell the story that apparently the hoods weren't fastened very well, so he told nobody to hit the brakes because the hoods come flying right off them. At the time, the 2+2 was, I was in charge of service, so you know I had a lot of customer interaction. And Bud would love to take me to his executive meetings over at the engineering center with all the heavyweights. And Bud had a candor and a directness about him that was really representative of our marketplace. I mean, he spoke for the customer every time he stood up, and he stood up a lot. One day I was in a meeting with all the executives, the VP and GM of North America, Stan Lancaster, and many other executives in the room. And Bud made one of his oratory remarks, speeches about shifting issues on the 86 series tractor. He said, "Sweet mother of God, I could make a transmission shifter better than that." And he looks at me and says, "Isn't that right, Vaughn?" And of course, I had to look at the floor and act like I didn't know who he was. It was a very awkward, but Bud Youle did that a lot. Bud Youle was a lightning rod for what was happening in the marketplace.
This concludes our segment for today. We're going to have more on the 2+2 and the impact of that machine. For the next episode, we're going to be talking about espionage, specifically how it happens in the agricultural equipment world. Lots of great stories there, including one from Mr. Youle talking about secrecy around the 2+2 program. Tune in for that. Drop a comment. We'd love to hear from y'all, and have a great day.
Very, very few people in the harvester company knew we were building this tractor.